Hi there, I've got some notes I owe you. First of all, from yesterday, sex-linked traits, and then we'll get on to 7-9, which had to do with pedigrees. All right, starting with sex-linked traits, we've been talking about all along that it doesn't matter if you're a boy or a girl as to what type of gene or trait you get. And so now what we're going to do is take a look at the fact that it actually does matter. Autosomal traits, like we said, are only here on the autosomes, or the ones labeled 1 through 22. But a sex-linked trait is completely different. It is actually found on, that's a really loud train going in my back. And we have these guys right here, the sex chromosomes, that carry particular traits as well. Specifically, they're usually only here on the X chromosome. And so for girls who are XX, you get two copies. And usually you get a good one and a good one, or a good one and a bad one. But every once in a while, girls can get two bad copies and show a particular trait. But since guys are missing a whole bunch of DNA right there, they only get one copy of a particular gene. So they either get the good one or the bad one. There's nothing in between. So let's take a look at how that works. All right, colorblindness is one of the more common and not so scary X-linked traits, in which you can, the person who has it cannot see certain color variations. So when we look at the Ishihara color blindness test, we see this one's quite easy because the two colors are quite different from each other, the blue and the red, and all the blues are the same shade and all the reds are the same shade. So you should be seeing the 12 in there. Now in this one, it starts to get a little difficult because now the reds are slightly different and the blues and greens in here are slightly different. So if you can see this well, you should see a number 5. This one here, there should see a number 8. In this one, you should see a number 3. Over here, there's a 29, and over here is a 15. So if you're colorblind, you are either unable to or have a very hard time discerning the difference between the numbers and the outside. So since it is sex-linked, and specifically X-linked, there's hardly any other Y-linked, because remember, teeny tiny Ys. So the X-linked ones, if it's X on the X, then each X in a female can carry a version of the allele, either a big or a small. But a boy, since he only has one X, he only carries one version of the allele. So females, if they're XX, female, and they have two versions of the normal vision gene, well, then they end up having totally normal vision. If they have one good copy, the normal vision gene, and a bad copy, well, it's okay because this follows complete dominance. So the big B is dominant over the little B, and therefore, again, she can see totally fine, but she does have the ability to pass it on to her offspring. So we call that a carrier. And then we have a colorblind female when both X's carry the colorblind gene. So there's no dominant one to overpower it. So we end up being colorblind. So this is kind of rare because statistically, to get a bad B from mom and dad is very difficult. Now a boy, it's a little bit different. Since a boy only has one X, he either gets the big version, which is normal color vision, or the bad version, which is a colorblind male. So chances of getting this was more like 50-50, depending on what your parents are. So since they only need one bad copy of the gene, they tend to get the colorblindness or the recessive alleles found on X-linked genes much, much more often than girls do. So we saw that in taking a look at the people in our class. All four of the periods of biology ended up having at least one or two people in there that were colorblind, all of them being male. Now, who do you get to blame for your colorblindness? Your mom. Because if you're colorblind, that means you got your X from your mom and your Y from your dad. Dad cannot give boys X's because, well, then they'd be girls. So if you are a colorblind male, go home and say, Mom, it's all your fault. Okay. Other examples of diseases that are also caused by X-linked traits that aren't or a little bit worse than colorblindness. One of them, hemophilia, as we can see right here. This giant bruise on her is caused by her blood vessels breaking inside of her. She probably just hit a table or something, but since they have the inability to clot in a proper amount of time, blood just leaks out into all the vessels everywhere and she ends up with a pretty gnarly bruise. Another one that's quite common is muscular dystrophy, and this one, as you can see, attacks the muscles of the whole entire body and prevents you able to move efficiently. Most people with this end up in wheelchairs and die at young ages because the muscle of their heart and diaphragm are unable to help them survive. So these are nasty ones. We like to deal with color blindness because, you know, oh, you can't see red and green, ha ha ha. But, you know, ooh, you have hemophilia. Yeah, we don't want to go there. So these are just some other examples of diseases, disorders that are caused by recessive genes found specifically on the X chromosome. chromosome. All right, that's it for sex-linked traits, nice and small. Thanks, guys. Bye.